Yahweh, by Hashem, Yahweh Shai, by Hashem, Rakaku Dash.
Never honor to the apostles, down, elders, and great hailstorm. Peace and blessings and success to y'all. This is about to go to Shalom. I'll be listening. We're going to get into it. You know, the news of the week.
Shake the hand that they may go to the gates of the nobles.
We all live in that battle. The Bible is true, you know, in front of Esau and his kingdom. So let them know he's going off, and all the other heathens, they going into slavery. And you know, and like you said, hey, we're going to be brought before those nobles. Because now they are talking about us in these Senate houses, you know, on these committees. About what they're going to do, or what direction should they take with these so-called black Hebrews, you know? And, you know, he can't wait to, well, he think he's going to get his hands on the man of the Lord, you know, 144,000, but hey, he reads in his poems, you know, with the biggest grin, like, yeah, I can't wait to one of these niggas, because, hey, he's going to get his new world order and send Moses. You know, these Rothschilds and Rockefellers, Gettys, and everything else, you know, they've been coming throughout, you know, through the reincarnation over and over, they actually want to pass. You know, they tired of sitting around with bullshit. Like, we want to see the kingdom, these devils want to see their new world order come, you know?
And they see us as the biggest obstacle to that, because ever since the men of the Lord, really beginning with our apostle elders, got onto the YouTube back in 2007, you see how much this verse has impacted the entire planet, how close we are to the end. So Esau's about to come with his move. Hey, it's going to be a catch 22 for him. Once he makes his move, especially against the men of the Lord, that's when he's going to get caught in a trick back, and the Most High's going to make his move. This is Psalms 37, verse 12. The wicked plotteth against the just and gnasheth upon him with his teeth.
Good.
I'm just going to say, his teeth. Hey. We know that teeth can go into weapons in the scripture, but we also know that Esau's got the physical weapons in his mouth, like a serpent tongue, gnashing with his teeth, with his legislation, with his words. That's what he's doing against the just, coming with these legislations, these black identity extremist bills, domestic terrorism bills, saying we're the biggest threat out there, etc., etc. Their sword shall enter into their own heart, and their bows shall be broken.
Whatever you do to you is going to fall back on you, Esau. You know, you can come in with your chains, your hem wraps, your armor humvees. All that don't scare the man of the Lord, man. We know how about Shem Yahweh Shai on our side, the Most High going to fight for us. You know, the scripture said that those are upright conversation. That's us, man. We were just a bunch of niggas over here in the hoods, slaying. slinging and banging, drinking all type of mump liquors, everything cool. Calling on Jesus Christ, that shit cool. But when you start to wake up and stick up for yourself, all right, and say, hey, I'm gonna stop letting that bully just tell me anything and do me anything. I'm gonna get on my shit, and that's the problem. You hate that we woke up, man. You hate that the Lord actually filled us up with spirit, right? The spirit, and he bred the light from us, man. That's what you hate. That's what you wanna, the upright conversation, that's what you wanna tear down. And that's gonna bite you in the ass, man, as it always does. But like I said, you're gonna convince the people that, hey, this weapons of mass destruction to Esau. We're gonna make this seem like weapons of mass destruction, and we're doing so much. Right? Who have we killed? What lines have we run crosses on, man? Right? What villages have we plundered and killed people, man?
Bound in the name of Jesus, right. Patriotism, yeah. Democracy.
Hey, what resources and minerals have we took? Right? What people have we dumped down? All right? What people have we actually put in the ghettos and slums and dumbed down and told them you just a bunch of niggas, blacks? And come every time in full circle to bite you in your ass.
Yeah. Yeah. And that's what he saw you thinking, man. He thought he spent all this money, these billions of dollars, trying to keep us in the dark. You know, because he, like I said, he wants that new world order. You know, he think he's gonna be able to come to fruition.
Sloppy you're getting, everybody's starting to get in on the okie doke. You're just a joke now. The name Rothschild, Rockefeller, DuPont, all that's just a joke. Because we know what your ultimate end is to go back to being the basest of men, to go back to being the bowers or the peasant or the servant that you always were. Nothing. You're gonna lick the dust off our feet, as it says, and the kings and their queens shall lick the dust of thy feet.
Exactly. Even though that standard won't get lifted up. He know that the heavenly father. That's why he gave the plan. You know? So when he come in thinking that he got the upper hand, thinking he gonna do what he did to all these other different sectors within Negroes, you know. Right? When you try to move in on the prophets, you're gonna find out the Heavenly Father got a steel wall in the midst of it.
You ain't gonna do what you did in back in Roman times. Prophets, you ain't gonna do it. Don't get it twisted. Some men will die when it comes to the election. You know, it's another ball, just another ball game. You ain't gonna do, even when the war comes back, you're not gonna do what you did back in the time of Roman times. Spit on them, beat the shit out of them. Give them. Yeah, but you ain't gonna give them a kiss, man.
This that Job you're talking about.
It's Job chapter 5, verse 12. He disappointed the devices of the crafty so that their hands cannot perform their enterprise.
Yeah.
Get all, don't think you got the world order pumping. looking out the window, I'm like, yeah, I got everything going, I got the chips and plants. You know, these fools, you know, sit down, you know, bring out that handkerchief, you know, try to stick it down his neck, and you're gonna cut that raw ass steak, and the minute you get into his mouth, the boss is gonna knock that shit out of his hand, and knock his fucking bitch ass down, you know?
Because, you know, when I get to the block, I'm gonna bring it out. But you all know, you know, like you said earlier, he's not so sloppy to run. How the fuck one Edomite as a whistleblower can make an hour and 30 minute video exposing you, your own shit? Y'all even doing right now with this, you know, C-19. All you been doing the whole time is playing them with microtransmitters in people, man.
Nanoparticles
has nothing more than transmitters in systems, right? For the Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi is gonna help push this ship. Right, as I said earlier, this ain't nothing more than a Trojan horse of what's to come. And we see the game. All you're doing is putting, like I said, these nanoparticles in people. That's why you got the, that's why a year before it even went down, you set up these Wi-Fi towers, man. These transmitters that you're putting, these particles on the C-19, swab, and in the bags, in the liquid. You know, they can track you. They got five action sensors in them where they can see how fast you're moving, the temperature of your body. That's all you've been doing. You've been playing games the whole fucking time, man. You know, and you've been exposed.
Right? Yeah. Yeah, that's why they gotta keep the vaccine at 70 degrees below temperature. Because it's actually alive, man. The vaccine is alive, what's going in.
Huh? Right, that's why
the max?
Yeah, Max.
But you know what? They gotta keep it, I think, at 70 degrees below temperature. And even when there was transporting, they couldn't close it in, like, or have it closed in because of the substance that's in it, man.
Yeah.
You got it, man.
Nanoparticles
attached
to your body.
They're fucking,
I know that person saying that. I gotta get around to talking to the same on that shit too. kinds of all kinds. Yeah. I know he's fucking circle web, take this shit. This shit goes for long, bro. Particles in the back, well, the back seat, you know. You know, we got these cryptocurrencies jumping, so we can throw in the chip. Hey, we got to figure it out, man. We'll see you coming from 2 miles away now, you know? Because these cryptos give the insight to the hell you could. You know, look out the chip down here now, you know? You know who the serpent is, you know who the devil is, you know, really? You see, he's part of sin is heaven, because one thing about us, man. It's a couple seconds that you can go into, but in order to control the people, there's only a couple things you gotta do. You gotta control the medical, you gotta control the money, you also gotta control the food and shit, man. And certain other things that can, and all roads lead to the chip, man. All roads lead to the chip. You need that, you already, since the third, I think, 1936 or some shit, you didn't control the medical.
Sort out. Going earlier with the Rockefellers, they were the ones that came up with the pharmaceutical industry before the 1920s and like the 19-teens and all that.
Dependency is at an all-time high in this society. They need what he provides. There was a video that I was watching about some people saying that he couldn't get the there was some type of insulin. When they skyrocketed up to a certain amount of money, they couldn't pay. They were balling because they need those things. You know, he saw that they created a society to where, hey, we can live without.
Stimulus checks. These people are begging for the next stimulus check.
Thank you.
all the men got together in the council and said, we got to get her out of the way because this will set a precedent where all the women in all the provinces will disrespect their husbands.
I'm talking about these different ones. I'm talking about when he summons the queen.
What her name? Vashanti?
Or whatever? Yeah, what? He summons her up and she ain't won't come.
Vashti,
right? Yeah. Vashti, she didn't want to come. And the law was made after that, or a decree made to all the women throughout the nation, like if you know, if you do something like that, or whatever the case may be, that is off until fucking end, man.
Con, I
know which one you're talking about, too.
Yeah, you were talking about the right, like, I thought that's what she did, but she didn't come up.
No, she didn't come up.
And that would have set a precedent for all women to be disrespected.
Which brought up, yes, I mean,
I know her name is Vashti.
No, Vashti just was the
she needed to be put to death like yesterday.
Got all that pride and all that ridiculousness.
The Edomites are trying to get a lot of women.
Yeah. That's
what I got a lot of women. There are a lot of women to basically. There are a lot of women to basically do their thing, man. Be how they look. Be told. Like, I come in the camp. I went to check out the pockets before I came. There's a car full of goddamn bras in the Jeep. Man, you know, they just walling out, about to show their breasts all the time. It is what it is, man. They allow them to do what the fuck they do, man. And these numbskulls, these copper tops in society, they fall suit because all they want to do, they need a woman, man. They tend, like, niggas got hit, especially in Louisiana, man.
This simp, central now. Ground zero for the simp, man. Jake killing everything in the city when it comes to that 4-4 woman. He don't play with us. She out there cursing him out. I tell them niggas what you really, you know, do. I'm talking about getting him together.
Yeah.
And he kill everybody in the project.
Yeah.
Women don't need men, they just go to daddy government. It's like daddy government right there.
He also read the scriptures. The devil knows the scriptures front to back. He also knows that the woman, how the man is to the woman, which he know how the woman feel towards the woman, towards the man. That's why he always attacked the woman. Even in the garden. Alright, he know. We get her, we got the man. Especially over here. You think he don't know Jeremiah 31:22? That a woman shall compass a man? He put a position to do it. Gave her housing, SNAP benefits, you know, everything, man. Jobs.
The breeding grounds for the teaching of the seven done in the church. That's what I mean for the trainers. Simple. Train your women up, believe this how it goes, and they get on you fucking men to be that. You niggas are simple. All you niggas are simple.
Southern hospitality
shit, bullshit.
Two times since Sunday, but still got his allegiance to us.
giving it. I can see you holding it. I see you giving the first, third, and the first, second, and third. You get red beans through the window from the bitch, man. Serious shit? You sleeping in the car. And then when a nigga do let you in, you don't shit too long, you sleep on the couch, man. Hey, man.
Your men already got it. Yes. That's what the elders say. The woman just gonna say, you can't stay, they got the children and it. She ain't gonna have to say what? No box. No box.
Yeah.
You ain't gonna get that shit, man.
We ain't about to take that COVID thing.
For real? I'm gonna get COVID.
You gotta get the COVID. Get the COVID first.
The max. The max.
Yeah.
Jail. You gotta get that jail. And it's already set up with daddy government, like, you gonna do? You gonna go against the court system and the government?
The woman really gonna be against you.
Yeah.
Because she all for the government. The government help her with everything. Yeah. Housing, food stamps, stimulus, WIC, assistance for the baby to go to child care. They gonna roll with the government.
I already got to the point. Alright? I'm gonna tell you, Jake, man. I'm out here pushing. This man finna come at you so hard behind the back, but he gonna try to tickle out of your kids. He gonna tickle out of your kids. But you don't own your kids.
He gonna take it. He probably took it already.
That's why he moves it.
He probably just took that for about an hour before he moves. Look, he about to go out. You heard me?
Yeah. Oh, he took man. That for
fast. He took both of them.
He took both of them. He took the Moderna and the Pfizer one.
Go ahead. Full time to go, man. But, you know, credit was edifying until you see some brothers on the other side listening.
We're almost out of here.